guys, and welcome back to the channel. We are here at IconiX by night this weekend, so it is Saturday today, and we are competing today, Sunday and Monday as well, because it's bank holiday. And I have with me, I have Neville today, and if we go right round, Luna is competing. Neville, you're just a cheerleader today, aren't you? You're just a cheerleader this weekend. You'll see I haven't got Lily with me this weekend because she has come into season and I don't want to risk anything. I also don't want to upset other dogs as well. She's about a week into her season as well, so she's well into it really. So I just don't want to risk her being kind of loose, attached in the garden area, and just in case a male manages to get out because he can smell her and he gets to her, I just don't want to risk it, especially with the other two dogs being here as well. That's just gonna cause absolute mayhem, and don't really want her in the van bleeding. I could put a nappy on her. I've not been using nappies, but yeah, it is kind of, it keeps going sunny then cloudy. It looks like, I don't know if you can see there, there is a massive, what looks like possible rain cloud, yay. So we'll see what happens. I can't walk any of my courses yet. I've been here a few hours already. It is 2 o'clock, and obviously this is by night, so everything's kind of done kind of afternoon, evening. The finals tonight and tomorrow night are like 11 till like 11:30 to 12, so tomorrow morning basically. So yeah, I'm just waiting to when I can walk a course, because I can't actually walk a course yet.
Luna, do you want to come and show everyone your dew claw? Hey?
So it's been, what, 2 weeks, hasn't it, Luna, since Casey I, when she tore her dew claw, and as you can see, it still looks a little bit swollen. So it does still look a little bit swollen. We ended up sedating her and cutting it right back short because it was just really wet. It wasn't drying. So yeah, I mean, it's still, I don't know, I think it still looks a bit swollen. I'm now in talks with the vets whether or not we end up just removing them, but they are attached, so it's not, yeah, it still looks a bit sore compared to, obviously this one's hairy, so it's difficult to tell. Getting a little nozzle that way. So as you can see, this one just doesn't, I mean, you can't really tell, it doesn't really stick out as much, but she has caught this one in the past as well. You can see the difference, you know, that one is sticking out quite a bit, so I am worried she is going to be catching it. So we will be wrapping your paws when we run. We've done training this week and group training, and she was absolutely fine, no concerns. We just wrapped them. She ran perfectly. She was off the week before because she would literally just been sedated to have it cut back. So we'll see. And we didn't practice any contacts at training this week, so we're gonna see what they're like, how much you remember of your contact criteria.
Tunnel.
on. Go on, go on. Woo-hoo!
Nina?
Yeah, did you get a clear? Did you get a clear in the jumping? Well done.
I can tell that I'm just getting over a cold because I'm so unfit. And I'm really struggling to catch my breath after that run. Like, I'm taking really deep breaths. I've still got like this cough as well. I literally only went back to work yesterday, so probably should not be running around a field during agility. But there we go. I've done the agility and I completely froze because she didn't stop on her dog walk. And even though she got the contact, I should have just kept running. I think I should just change it to a running dog walk because honestly, she's getting it all the time at the moment. And hey ho. Anyway, she didn't stop. So she didn't stop. I then froze because I was like, do I put her back on it? In my mind, I'm going like, do I put it back on it? But she got the contact, so what do I do? I froze for a second. Anyway, she'd gone straight into the tunnel and I was like, right, just keep going then. Rear cross, and then I was obviously not running to the next jump. I was thinking about the weaves, so she missed that jump. And then a big fat elimination. Everything else was lovely. Such a beautiful seesaw, lovely A-frame. Like, she got a lovely running A-frame. The rest of it couldn't have done any better. She did amazing. Then we've done the jumping now. We literally just got back. It's 6:10 and we've just got back to the van. I've just put, if you can probably hear it boiling away or trying to boil away, and I've just put the kettle on for a cup of tea. And sorry now. Yeah, so I've just done the jumping. 1-3 graded and she got clear. We are currently sitting in 5th, but obviously there's still a few dogs to go. And if I think it was the top 6 dogs from combined, so that was the agility I did this morning, so top 6 from the combined class, and then whoever wins the graded classes, so like 1 from grade 1, 1 from grade 2, and 1 from grade 3, all of them, they'll go through to the final tonight. So we've missed out on that, although we have got another run yet, so we've got another agility run later, but that'll be after 8 o'clock now. 8 o'clock? I'm flagging already. I think just because I've been flagging by like 4 o'clock anyway at the moment, just because of this cold. But there we go. Luna's been running, as you can see. I've wrapped her feet up in vet wrap. She's running absolutely fine in them, so we're just going to keep going with that. Just got to get into the habit of actually wrapping them and making sure that I keep wrapping them. Anyway, going back to the jumping. Sidetrack there. Absolutely beautiful. I left her in the weaves and just kept running because I was so worried. Like, at the moment, I'm not running as fast as I normally would. I was worried that I wasn't going to keep up with her because it was like jump tunnel like all around the back of the ring back to the front, so I was worried I wasn't going to catch up with her. And yeah, did that, left her in the weaves, which was amazing. Finished the weaves, absolutely beautiful. I could not have asked for a better run from her, so happy with that. Gonna make a cup of tea, gonna go and walk this other course, and it is definitely going to be dark and we're going to be running under the floodlights. It's going to be so cool. Look at his happy face. She doesn't realise. Luna, the class is closed. Do you want to know where you came? You didn't place, I'm afraid. Someone pipped you out of 4th place. So they were going up, they were giving out to 4th place. And we were sitting in 5th. I know, Nev. 0.1 of a second. 0.1 of a second. And she would have beaten them. That's what it was, 0.1 of a second. How crazy is that? Like, literally the top 4, including Luna, so the top 5, we were all like 26.6, 26.7, 26.8. So close, my darling, but we got a clear round. You did amazing in my eyes, beautiful. She don't care, she's knackered already. I mean, it is 6:20, so. sausage. That was a lovely run. Lovely running dog walk that we've not taught you, but there we go.
So that was a pretty cool experience running in the floodlights. It is pretty much pitch black out there now. So we were running in the arena with the floodlights on. Yeah, that was so cool. So we didn't place. She had 10-fault, 5-4, not getting the A-frame contact. She was just slightly too high. And then 5 for the weaves. She popped out literally on the second to last weave. Luckily I managed to, she ran straight for the tunnel, and luckily I managed to like pull her back off the tunnel so she didn't go in there. So I just put her back through the weaves. Again, she did the weaves then perfect. Everything else was beautiful, seesaw beautiful. Dog walk, she did a beautiful running dog walk again. I should just say that I trained her to do a running dog walk because honestly, it's so good. No stop, but there we go. The rest of it was absolutely beautiful. It was literally just them two things. So, but really lovely weight at the start. So I can't, honestly, I was really pleased with that run actually. And just for the experience of running under the floodlights. So we haven't got through to the final. Final is meant to start at 11 o'clock and it is 9:15 now. I'm gonna try and stay up because I am really flagging. I'm really feeling it now. I mean, you can probably hear in my voice how much I'm kind of struggling.
Morning and happy campers. So I'm just out walking the dogs. Neville's back there. So he's off lead just because he can be trusted a little bit more to not go absolutely crazy. Whereas Luna is on lead because she is crazy. I did let her off a minute ago and she went off diving into some bushes, typical Spaniel. And she's got like loads of sticky, like spiky leaves that I now can't get off her, so she's back on the lead. It's a nice little thing. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just walking, found a little path. So I'm just gonna walk and see where it takes me around the polo club. We'll see where I come out. So last night ended up being quite a late night / very early morning this morning. I didn't get back to the van until like 12:30 after we watched the finals. I had to put like 4 or 5 layers on. I was really cold to watch it. And then I got back into my sleeping bag. I am so glad I packed my winter sleeping bag because it was freezing cold. I put the dogs in the jumpers because I was like, I don't want them being cold overnight. If I'm cold, they're probably cold. So they got their pajamas. And yeah, otherwise it was a nice night. I've had a nice lay in this morning. So now, like I said, we're just gonna chill until we can course walk at like 11:40. I've got 2 jumping and 1 agility today, so. 1 in the morning and we have just got back from watching the final. And look where these two have just, I've just sorted the bed out and everything, and these two have just decided they're gonna sleep in the same bed. How cute. Night guys, see you tomorrow. Just done our first run of the day, which is agility, which is never good because she flies. She has so much energy. So wasn't a great run. Didn't quite fly the seesaw, but it was enough to make me put her back on anyway. And then she got the dog walk, but flew it. So again, put her back on. Rest was okay. She got weaves nice. But no, she was just wild. Told her right and she was just really wide. So need to work on that. Absolutely super run, wasn't it, Luna? Luna, was that a good run? That was a really good run, wasn't it? Good girly. Oh my god, that was such a good run. She felt so good in that. Such a good run. She just flowed. The only bit was I just didn't make sure she'd committed to the out before I kind of pulled away, so she didn't jump over the jump, so I just put it back over. So we got a 5-4, a refusal, but otherwise so pleased with that. That ran so beautifully. And I even managed to get the blind at the top because I was worried, like the blind just before the weaves, because I was going to front cross it because I didn't think I'd get there in time. But she did it. Yay. Go find Nev. Where is he? Where's Neville? Yeah, there he is. Some very cheeky self-releases on the A-frame and dog walk, but she got both the contacts, so I just kept going. Saved her from going over a jump after the dog walk, which was quite good. She got the weaves nice, and then I just lost connection on the out to then bring her back round on this hand. Otherwise it was a really lovely run. She got a seesaw, beautiful seesaw, so really pleased with that. Anyway, as you can see, I am all packed up, so wind breaks are gone. So time to go home. That's it, we're done. We had some good runs, to be fair. Actually they were all really good runs, to be honest. Just odd things here and there that we need to work on, and we've definitely got to get these contacts sorted. I'm toying with the idea of changing her to a running contact anyway. It's just having the time to be able to. So I'm toying with the idea of changing Luna anyway to a running contact, but try and still keep her
stop contact, but I don't know whether that's going to be possible just with the time that I have available to even be able to train it. How, you know, we only do one group lesson a week, and then I try and train a little bit in the garden as well, but our garden's quite small, so it's going to be difficult to do like a running dog walk and training in the garden. So I'd have to think about potentially hiring somewhere else kind of midweek as well, so that we've got two training sessions a week on it. So I don't know. We got our clear round on the first day, so cute little clear round rosette there. And then this was from yesterday, the third in, what was that? That was in the jumping with, she had 5 faults for that one. But I mean, I'm really pleased. I mean, we've only got round one clear. Everything else has been faults or E's, but they've been good faults, good E's, if that makes sense. Like, it's been a good run, but it's been like one little thing that's kind of faulted us. And that's, yeah, it just gives us training points to work on anyway. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed coming along this weekend to us to IconiX by night and had great fun. I absolutely loved running under the lights in the dark. Like, that was a complete experience. I can't wait to do it next year. So I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please give us this video a thumbs up. If you want to see more agility videos, then please do subscribe to us. Click that notification bell as well so that you are notified every time a new video goes out, and we will see you again next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.